Hey there, folks. Welcome to another edition of Time About the Movies. If you saw the last video I just posted, I'm just coming back from Still City Con. It was a long weekend. I'm kind of tired. I'm not really in the best shape right now to do this because, you know, we've been working so hard the last couple days, but I'm going to pull through. If you want to see that video, by the way, I'll put a card at the on the corner here so you can see it. But we are in September of 1989, and before we get to the new releases, I did want to start off with a movie that I honestly completely forgot about, because when I looked on Box Office Mojo, which is the website I go to, it did not have this movie on any of the other, on the list for this particular weekend, for this movie I'm about to talk about, and that is Pink Cadillac.
Clint Eastwood is a fugitive hunter, and he's full of surprises and disguises in Pink Cadillac.
That's right, cowboy.
Up at 6 o'clock in a long black limousine, Batesy baby.
Oh, he's good. There's no question about that. He's so good, he's got to die.
The birthright game has a score to settle, and they'll stop at nothing. But Bernadette Peters is Clint's biggest trouble, and he's hot on her tail. Once he finds her, he's in for the ride of his life.
Obviously a hardened criminal. I can tell by the cupid bow lips. This is so wrong. Oh, this is a grade A U.S. government green.
Give me a break.
Too much raw dude for you, huh, babe? Well, I can dig it. If my life were a movie, there'd be a sign on it saying, caution, some scenes are too intense for younger viewers.
Yeah! It's a contact sport!
Clint Eastwood, Bernadette Peters, a wild pair on a fast ride.
The room.
Didn't anyone ever tell you you shouldn't mess with a man's vehicles? Pink Cadillac.
Yeah, sorry about that. My hand slipped when I was filming that trailer, but yeah, this came out on Memorial Day weekend, 1989, but when I went to Box Office Mojo, the only new movie that was on there was Indiana Jones and The Last Crusade, which I already did that one. I did a full review of the full episode on that one, but I didn't realize until I looked on there again, I was wondering, wasn't Pink Cadillac released around this time in the summertime? But when I looked at it, when I looked at the list, it was not there. And I'll show you what I mean. Let me show you what I mean. Yeah, so here's May 26th again. That's the only highlighted film up there, Indiana Jones. But Pink Cadillac was not there, was not highlighted on this page. Nor was it on this page, which just only shows you Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade. I only knew it came out this weekend because if I go to the next page for the next week, week number two for Pink Cadillac. So that's why it took me a while to get to this one, unfortunately. So if anyone was waiting to hear my thoughts on this, which I don't know why you would, here you go. Here's my thoughts on Pink Cadillac. I don't even know what the hell that was. I'm sorry. Like I said, I'm trying my best to get through this. I'm tired. It's been a long weekend. But anyway, Pink Cadillac. Yeah, this is not one of Clint Eastwood's best movies, unfortunately. I mean, God bless him. He's trying his best here. He's having fun with this, it seems like. He's got Bernadette Peters in here. Anytime you have Bernadette Peters in there, you automatically up the quality of a movie. But this movie really does not have any quality to it. Like, the best thing about this movie is Eastwood and Peters. They're both great together. Unfortunately, they're just not really given a whole lot to do here. A lot of what's in this movie is kind of generic, kind of forced, and doesn't really work as well as I think they wanted it to. I mean, this is directed by the same guy that did Any Which Way You Can, and actually did the Deadpool, which was the last Dirty Harry movie that came out a year before this, and that was actually a pretty good Dirty Harry movie. That was actually a pretty surprisingly good Dirty Harry movie that I don't think a lot of people really talk about. It's one of the early Jim Carrey movies, who's also in this one as well. And, yeah, the jokes in this one just really didn't work all that well, but like I said, Eastwood and Peters, they're trying their best here to make this work, and I'm not going to lie, there are a couple moments where I'm just kind of like, okay, that's kind of funny, that's kind of intriguing, but nothing that I would really say is laugh out loud funny or anything, but Yeah. That's my thoughts on Pink Cadillac. Not really a good movie, but I liked Eastwood and Peter, so that movie's taken care of. We can move on to the next, to the new releases this weekend, and we have Relentless.
Officer Ike Taylor was so respected, so admired.
Ike Taylor! Hello, cop.
There was only one way his son could turn out.
I'll tell you that on the job.
It wouldn't take
me. It wouldn't take you, Ike Taylor's kid. Taylor's.
Buck Taylor doesn't need a gun. He's got the telephone.
Hello?
I called to see if you were home. I have to kill you. Tonight.
This lunatic is trying to show the world that he can pick anybody at random from a phone book and kill him.
You know, there's about 12 million people in L.A. One of them decides it's open season on people.
He knows your name.
One of them, Sam, against you and me.
He has your address.
Hit again last night. Twice.
It's all right.
He's got your number.
What do I do now? Tell me, please.
And you're about to be disconnected.
But if you act like a victim, you're gonna be a victim. My father said I was sick. Once.
Judd Nelson is Buck Taylor. And Buck Taylor is Relentless.
So this is basically just a generic slasher film. I mean, the killer is basically just taking random names from a phone book and saying, yeah, this is good. This is a good person I need to kill right now. That's pretty much what this trailer is implying here. I haven't seen this movie, but yeah, there's nothing about this trailer that's really making it stand out or anything. Like, it just doesn't look all that impressive. And this is a shame because this is written by Phil Oliver Robinson, who had just written Field of Dreams, which is a big hit for him. Howard Koch, who also was the producer on Airplane at the start of the decade, is also a producer on this movie. I mean, it's got a decent cast to it. You got Judd Nelson, you got Robert Loggia, you got Ron Taylor, you got Meg Foster. It's a decent cast in here, but I don't know. There's just nothing here that just makes this stand out as anything other than just a generic slasher film. It's just, like, I don't find Judd Nelson threatening in this at all. He's been threatening in movies before, but just not this movie. I mean, this looks like a pretty bad movie, and this is done by the same people that also did Maniac Cop and basically the Maniac Cop trilogy, which are better movies, but this just looks like just kind of a generic crime thriller, like a generic slasher film. That's just my thoughts on that one. Let's go ahead and move on to the second movie that came out this weekend, and that is...
Is this it? Have you finally gone round the friggin' pipe?
We always have steak on Thursday.
I'm not eating shite.
Mother, you haven't put enough sugar in this cocoa. You go down and get us another spoon.
She's only been back 5 minutes and she's got me strutting around like R2 bleating D2.
Hiya, Wall.
What's wrong with that?
There's a woman 3 doors down, talks to a microwave. Talking to a microwave. Whoa, what's the world coming to?
I think sex is like supermarkets. Just a lot of pushing and shoving and you still come out with very little at the end.
The only thing I ever wanted to do was travel. I'd like to drink a glass of wine, sitting by the sea, watching the sun go down.
Not a feminist, not like Jane. All men are potential rapists. Even the Pope.
Shirley Valentine got married to a boy called Joe. But somewhere along the way, the boy called Joe turned into him.
I always have my tea at 6 o'clock.
World exclusive. Joe eats late.
We were at school together. Marjorie's an air hostess now.
I'm not an air hostess. I'm a hooker.
Greece for the sex.
sex for breakfast, sex for dinner, sex for tea, and sex for supper.
Sounds like a marvellous diet, love.
It's called the F plan.
I hardly recognise myself these days. I love it here. Don't I rock? I've got this little dream about sitting at a table by the edge of the sea.
I move table to edge of sea. I make your dream come true.
The only holiday romance I've had is with myself. And I think I've come to like myself, really. I've fallen in love with the idea of living.
Shirley, who are you talking to?
The wall, Costas. Just the wall.
My God.
I'm Shirley the Brave. Shirley the Marvelous. Shirley Valentine.
What happened? Oh, yeah. Shirley Valentine, which, I'm sorry for that. Shirley Valentine, yeah, that was kind of boring. I mean, yeah, I got nothing on this one. Look, I understand what this movie is trying to be. I understand the people that would like this movie. I mean, this is based off of a one-person show, which Pauline Collins actually reprised her role from the show. But other than that, though, it's just kind of like, cool. I mean, you still didn't make a good movie. I mean, nothing about this trailer was all that interesting at all, and the movie itself was just kind of, okay, maybe I'm being a little too harsh. It wasn't the worst, but there was really nothing about it that made it stand out, honestly. Like, I'm watching this and I'm thinking, where's the enjoyment factor here? What am I getting out of this? I mean, maybe if I'm watching this on a Broadway stage or a Broadway stage or something, maybe I'd be more interested in. But this is a movie, and I don't know. To me, it just didn't work for me. I know there are people that like this movie, but to me, I just thought it was not. I didn't hate it, but I didn't like it either. It was just kind of generic to me. Like, it was generic, it was kind of boring. I mean, this cast is trying their best. Everyone here is at least trying their best here. It just didn't work for me. I know some people who like this movie, but me personally, I didn't like it. So, that's my thoughts on Shirley Valentine as I move the camera. So, that was Labor Day 1989, and it was not a very good weekend. But you know what? There was a lot of other good movies that came out that people wanted to go see again, and they just went to go see that. Those films again. I mean, Uncle Buck is still number one. It's like the fourth week. It's the number one movie. Parenthood is still there. When Harry Met Sally. People are still going to see The Abyss more than they are going to see movies like this, like Relentless and Shirley Valentine. That just shows you how lackluster of a stretch we're in right now. But next time around, next week, we have Jean-Claude Van Damme and Kickboxer, which is the only new release that came out this week, and usually I do a full review on movies like this, but I don't know too much about Kickboxer, honestly. So, probably won't be a full review. I'll try to see what I can do here. But other than that, though, next time around, we'll do Kickboxer. So, thank you for watching this episode. I promise you're going to get a better one, because I'm going to be more wide awake next time. Like I said, I'm literally doing this after we just finished the Steel City Con, so I apologize if this is not the best position that I'm in right now. So thank you for watching, and if you want to see more videos like this, go ahead and hit the like and subscribe button, and check out the next page, which features the playlist and the previous episode. I'll see you guys tomorrow for the next episode, which is going to be Kickboxer. So thank you for watching. I'll see you guys tomorrow, and until then, take care. Good night.